Wow, such a gorgeous day. I know all you peeps are having your heat waves and good weather, but we have it year round. Look. You know what? It's been put on my heart to tell you, my peeps. Listen, my peeps. From my own personal experience, look how beautiful. Look how beautiful God has blessed me. Do you know God blesses you and keeps you? Do you know the Lord will make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you? You know the Lord will lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace? Do you know the word of God says he will keep you, your mind, you in perfect peace, whose mind is set upon him? So when things are troubling you, my peeps, you know what you're supposed to do? Keep your mind set on the Lord. Take out his word, study, and show yourself approved of him. And let it sink into your spirit and your heart. And it will send you peace from above. Because in this world, I'm sorry, there's going to be trouble. There's going to be tribulation. There's going to be sorrows. There's going to be griefs. But guess what? The Lord Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, has overcome the world, he said in his word. He says, fret not thyself for evildoers, my people. Let me tell you something. The evildoers can be your family, people. You know what you need to do? You need to check people. And when I say check them, I mean check as in back check them. Back check your people. Back check your mama. I'm telling you, my people, my own personal experience, my very own close sisters and brother, aunt, and cousins, people I grew up with, people I shared the womb with. Do you know these people conspired with strangers to murder me? And I'm just going about my business in my life, not bothering anybody, just loving, living, laughing, thinking these people are on my side. They're smiling in my face. Remember that song? What was it? The OJs? See, I'm from the old school, my people. I know some of y'all in here, this page is young and dumb. Y'all don't remember the old sound, the old school music. Marvin Gaye, the OJs. There was a song back in the day called Smiling in My Face. All the time they want to take my place. They're backstabbers. Backstabbers. I'm going to play it for you. Oh, I'm going to put my music on and get my therapy going. But backstabbers are in your family. They're not just your neighbors. They're not just the people on your job looking at you saying, how you get that promotion? How did you get that car? Why can't... That's called covetousness. A spirit of covetousness is on these people in my family. They lust after things of the world. And they looked at me and said, how you get that house? How did you get that car? How did you get your peace? And I'm exemplifying before these people every day of my life that I love myself, the Lord Jesus Christ. But yet, they refuse to accept the word and the spirit that is in me. Instead, they sought to slaughter me, people. Slaughter me like a dog. Do you know I wouldn't have tried to kill a dog the way these people tried to kill me? That's why I'm telling you, my people. Check them. Check everybody. I don't care if it's your baby. I don't care if you birthed them out of your, strained and pushed them out of your womb. Check that sucker when he gets able to walk and breathe and talk. When you cut that cord. Now, I'm not saying the little bitty, sweet little babies. what I'm talking about when they start walking up and start thinking they can. You know how they are when they get 13, 14. They think they know everything. Because we did it. I thought I knew everything. But my people, this generation, as the word of God says, it's wiser to do evil. As we draw closer to the end times, mother against daughter, sister against sister, brother against brother. And that's happening right now. I'm testifying to you people that we're drawing closer to the shutdown of this wickedness in this world. The king is coming home. Do you hear me? The king is coming back, and he's coming back with a wrought iron to get rid of this wickedness in our world. That's why I'm gonna start being a billboard, a signpost. Well, my family tried to murder me, but I can still be a witness before these wicked ones from a distance now. Now, I'm not that into. I'm into the word, but the Lord said, thou shalt live. So I want to live because, you know, these people tried to murder me, so I can't be up in their face preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. But I can send it to them from a YouTube. Or I can send it to them from a text. Never will I be in the midst of these people that tried to slaughter me. And I'm telling you, people, you better check who's in your circle. Smiling in your face. Go listen to that song. You better read, listen to it, let it get into your head. Smiling in your face. All the time they want to take your place. They're backstabbers. They're coming in from the back to stab you, to slaughter you for the things of this world. People, check who's in your family. Check your neighbor. When they come smiling in your face, hi there, stepping over to your house, can I borrow a cup of sugar? You say, no, sugar. You can't borrow nothing from me. Go to the store and borrow it. They got a whole bunch of sugar at the store. You can go borrow it from there. Because those, I'm not going to curse because this is a very family-oriented channel. But I'm telling you, people. People amongst your own want to kill you. And my mind is blown. I'm talking holy roly people. People, do you know what the holy rollers are? Let me school you. Holy rollers. You used to go to church. And the women and the men, when they got the skull, so-called spirit, they start jumping and shouting and knock you. They fall down on the floor and start rolling around, hollering out Jesus' name and hallelujah. And they put on a big act, the wigs fall off, the girdles come down. Those people are called holy rollers. Them Pentecostal holy rolling people are the ones stabbing you in your back. You understand what I'm telling you? I grew up in a church with these people. And these people calling out the name of my Lord Yeshua. And they trying to kill for money. Lusting after the things of this world. Prosperity preaching. But they don't have the love of Jesus Christ. And you know what the word of God says? Those very same people, when Jesus comes back, they're going to be falling down, holy rolling. Lord, Lord, Lord. You know what Jesus is going to do? He's going to look at them. You've seen that look on people. They just look at you like, what? Jesus, see, y'all don't know the Jesus I know. He's cool. He's going to be like, who are you? I don't know you. Step off. Get back. I never knew you. These holy rollers gonna say, but remember, Lord, when I was in the church falling down, holy rolling, remember when my girdle fell off, remember when my wig fell off? The Lord gonna say, that ain't me. I'm not into you rolling around like a damn fool on the floor. I didn't tell you to do that. I didn't tell you, but I do know one thing. You tried to kill your sister,
I remember that because she got on her knees and she prayed to me about it. You tried to kill my servant who gets up every morning and praises me and loves me, and I love to hear her sing to me, but you tried to kill her. Now, I remember that. People think Jesus is blind. They think he's deaf. They think he's dumb. He sits on high, but he sees down low, and he sees a lot of you low down ones. You low down, dirty ones. He see what you're doing in your closets. He see what you're doing in those back rooms. He see what your thoughts. He see your heart. You can't fool the Lord Jesus. When he comes back with that rod, you better get down on your knees and let him break your back. Because that's what he's going to do. Break it over your back. I don't know you. He's going to slam the door in your face. He's going to dish you. Because you're dishing him when you step on his servants, when you false witness, when you covet, when you steal, rob, kill the love that he planted in his children. Don't touch his anointing. What would happen if somebody came in your house and start bogarting your kids around, pushing them around, kicking them around, trying to kill your kids? Now, what mother or father gonna sit there and just let that happen? Well, don't you know Jesus is a father and a mother? Don't you know he's a brother and a sister? Don't you know the Lord loves his people? But the difference between him and you is he got all power and authority. You better drop. You better stop. You better get to know him. You better repent. Because the Lord's and his day is at hand. I'm out.